I'm Scott Shannon. We're counting down the top 30 smash hits of the week, all the way to the number one song in the USA. A special Rockin America happy birthday goes out today to Neil Young, Greg Lake from Emerson, Lake & Palmer, Mr. Roy Wood, who used to be an ELO, Mary Travers from Peter, Paul & Mary, and Joni Mitchell. Happy birthday, Joni, wherever you are, and we love you. David Bowie's getting ready to film his first primetime special. The Glass Spider Tour will be a one-hour special on ABC TV. It'll tape it this month at a concert in Australia.
Fleetwood Mac takes to the road, brought to you by Kenwood Electronics. Christine McVie says, for the band, there's one thing that's certain.
I don't think this tour is going to be any shortage of fun.
Catch the excitement when Fleetwood Mac rocks Atlanta November 9th, New Orleans the 10th, Houston November 12th, Austin on the 13th, and Dallas the 15th. And hear the latest on Fleetwood Mac on the Westwood One radio network.
I'm going to make it happen. I'm going to learn a lot. Now I can make the most of everything I've got.
If you're a young person just getting started, a little extra income could feel pretty good right now. That's what a nearby Army Reserve unit offers. Part-time income with a chance to learn another skill. And for just one weekend a month, usually a couple of eight-hour days, and 2 weeks annual training, you can start out earning over $80 a weekend. Think about it. Learn a useful skill and get paid for it. $80 for a weekend of training that could be useful in your career. So if you can spare 1 weekend a month and 2 weeks annual training, you could get a real change of pace and get paid for it. Give us a call. We're the Army Reserve. We're in the yellow pages under recruiting.
Be all that you can be. Find your future in the Army Reserve.
Paid for by the Army Reserve.
Excuse me, did you just leave your bathroom without doing a certain something?
No, I didn't. But thanks so much for barging into my home and asking.
Maybe something that begins with L and fights bad breath by killing plaque and other germs that cause it?
Listerine. Listerine antiseptic.
That's right.
How could I forget something like that? How could I? Oh, you know, it's no excuse, but I have been under a lot of stress lately, and the light was bouncing off the fixtures right in my eyes.
Listerine works hard to fight bad breath, so get back in the bathroom and do it.
Hi, this is Nick Van Eed from Cutting Crew, and he is...
I'm Kevin McMichael, and you're listening to the Westward One radio network.
The group Cutting Crew got a gold album for selling more than a half million copies of their first album, Broadcast. And one of the songs on that LP, I Just Died in Your Arms, made it all the way to number one on our show. Their current single is I've Been in Love Before, and that one's a big hit, too. The lead singer for the band Cutting Crew stopped by the Rockin' America studios, so we asked Nick Van Eed what in the world is coming up next for Cutting Crew.
A question everybody's asking us now, isn't it? Can we follow that up? And I really think we can, you know, because I always thought this first album would be our record deal. We just got the record deal. Let's get a Cutting Crew record out. Because it was all thrown together in those early days, you know, like producers, hodgepodge here, there, which studio, the band even. And then, you know, next album, get things happening. Christ, it's gone mad from day one. So I really think it's only going to get better for us. I really do, because we've got some great songs in the pipeline.
Nick Van Eed and Cutting Crew moving up 3 points this week to number 13 on the countdown with I've Been in Love Before.
Catch my breath, close my eyes. Don't believe a word. Things she said.
Small.
Cutting Crew, and I've Been in Love Before. Number 13 this week on the official Rockin' America Top 30. You're listening to the Rockin' America Top 30 Countdown. I got some bad news for you Clarence Clemens fans. The big man doesn't play any saxophone at all on Bruce Springsteen's new album. Well, at least he gets to sing a few background vocals on the LP. Maybe that's because Clarence is working on a brand new album of his own. Meanwhile, his boss, Bruce Springsteen, moves up 4 points this week on Rockin' America to number 7. Here's Bruce and Brilliant Disguise. I'm Scott Shannon. You're listening to the Rockin' America Top 30 Countdown, and we do appreciate it. Well, things are definitely looking up for a lady named Belinda Carlisle. Nobody knew exactly what would happen to her after the band The Go-Go split up, but it looks like she's doing just fine. This week, Belinda Carlisle's got the Rockin' America Chartbuster of the Week. Oh my God. That's the record that moves up the chart faster and farther than any other song. This week, it jumps up 8 points from number 20 to number 12. The Rockin' America Chartbuster of the Week, Belinda Carlisle, and Heaven is a Place on Earth.
Ooh, baby, do you know that?